A little bit ago, I started a mini-series to show y'all how I do what I do as a YouTuber. I started it off with how I edit my videos, and since then, y'all requested to see so much more of what I do. Today is finally part two of this series, and we're tackling my intro. Take a look. Hey y'all, what is up? It is Marissa Nicole and welcome back to my channel. I'm sitting here at my desk in front of my window, so I'm sorry if my lighting changes at all during this intro, because today I am sitting down and I am sharing with you guys how I make my intros. I have gotten so many comments on how I do this, especially since I've started this little mini series, and I recently just finished making this new intro that you guys just watched, because since I recently graduated from college, I decided that I wanted to take my channel through a rebranding process, because I am no longer Marissa Nicole helping you conquer college. I'm Marissa Nicole helping you tackle post-grad life. I don't know. I need a catchy slogan again. So I changed my profile picture. I changed the header of my channel, if you guys haven't noticed which. If you guys want a video on how I do that specifically, let me know in the comments down below. I can make that the next part of the series if you guys want to. And then I tackled my intro, which took me so many hours. And I didn't screen record or film it at the time, because usually when I do things like this, I'm going through so many creative like processes or ideas, and I try out one thing and I don't like it, so I try another thing, and it is very jumbled on my end, let alone if you guys were trying to follow it and watch it. So I did not real time record myself make my intro, but what I'm gonna do today is basically go back through and remake it for you guys and actually screen record, walk you through how I did it, so you guys can see how I make my intros on Final Cut Pro. If you're new here, please consider subscribing down below, clicking that notification bell, that way you get notified every time I post a new video, and don't forget to follow me over on Instagram, and let's get started. All right, so we're doing this full voiceover style, so I can show you guys exactly how I made this intro here. I already have my music here in my project that I'm going to be making my intro in, and the first thing I need to do is of course put in the background that I was using for my intro, which I found on Pinterest. I knew that I wanted something pink, of course, because that is really my vibe here, so I looked up like pink aesthetic. You guys can look through different pictures that you're wanting. I also wanted something subtle, so I know that I looked up some watercolor stuff until I came across the photo that I wanted to use, and I saved it from Pinterest so that way I can use it on my laptop here. I wanted to kind of blur out the background, make it more fun and not so harsh, I guess. So I did add a couple different effects to the background itself, one being the effect radial, which is in Final Cut Pro already, but it's just a little too much for me. I'm gonna drop it down to about 13, and that looks better. I did increase the scale of it to be about 200, because as you can see, there's like black edges around it, and I don't want to be able to see that, so I just zoomed in on a photo so that way you couldn't see any of the edges through the radial. And then I also added the effect underwater to it, but to me that was a little too harsh, so I did drop those down to an 8, a 20, and a 200, so that way it moved a little bit more slowly and it was still moving. And so I googled some little trendy stars online so that way I could find some that I liked, and I added the same underwater effect to this so that they kind of moved together. And then the last thing for the background that I wanted to add was basically a filter that kind of looked like a VHS tape. And so I did download a pack from Max Novak, and it is free. You guys can look it up and kind of download it. So that's what I did. It comes with a whole bunch of things, but the one that I wanted to use in this video is this Free Dirt Vintage. And so if I just drop that down over my footage here, it is black at first, but to make a background like this transparent, in the composting, all you're gonna do is change it to subtract. So that way it's subtracting out the black and you're left with kind of these VHS dirt and lines going through it. And this is the base of my intro. And now we can start the fun part of actually adding in the footage and stuff. Obviously you've heard my intro music before. It has a little snap that it cuts to the intro before it actually starts playing the intro. And you can see that here in these wavelengths that I've cut off and isolated here. So within this little snap before the intro actually starts, I wanted to add my little Marissa Nicole. And I do that by selecting a basic title. We're gonna write in Marissa Nicole. We're gonna change the font to Cool Vetica, which is a font that I believe I downloaded into my Final Cut. I'm not sure if you guys come with this, but this is what I use. I'm gonna up it to maybe 200, add an outline and my drop shadow. I outline with black, and then my drop shadow, I outline with my branding kind of pink color. And I want the distance for this to be about 15 so you can actually see that. We're gonna move it here to the center. And then what's also along with my branding are like the little hearts that go around my stuff. So I can do the same thing just by copying and pasting these things. And I'm gonna pull up my little heart symbol. This little one is the one that I use on everything. So I can just copy that, paste it in here. And then of course we'll have to resize these, but I paste these on the sides of my name. And that's my little heart branding and how I do that. And then comes the footage. So the inspiration for my new intro comes from the new header that I made. So I wanted to pull in a lot of aspects of that. And so we're starting with this kind of area. We're gonna move on to this area. And then we go on to this area and this area. So I kind of hit on all of the things in my header. I wanted footage of me along with Polaroids, along with other effects. And so I'm pulling in the footage that I wanna use for this clip. I'm gonna drop down the audio because we don't wanna hear it. And then I'm gonna find the areas that I want and kind of cut that up. And we have these two pieces of footage that I would like to use together for this little section. And I cut up my sections based on the music, but as you can see, you can't see the background, which is of course what I want to be seen. So I'm going to downscale it to 90 just so I can see the edges of it. I like to add a simple border around these things, which is an effect that is inside of Final Cut. And I make the border a 10 width, and the border is just white just to kind of go along with the white stars in the background and just like the light airiness of the video. And then I want to add more effects. So Polaroids and little effects that are happening on my screen. And I want it to go with the music. So of course that's going to take some timing. That's going to take you guys figuring out where you want it to happen based on what's going on, where your drop beats are, all of that good stuff, which of course I have already figured out where I want the things. So we're just going to place them to make the Polaroids in my intros. And just like my Polaroids usually in everywhere, like my headers and everything, I use the app Unfold, which is basically like a stories app. I have the templates here for different Polaroids because I like the style of this Polaroid. It looks very realistic. These two go with the footage that I want to use. I'm just going to save each of these to my device. And once I get them over here on my computer, I'm going to use just the preview app. If you press this little like magic wand, click and drag it, it'll kind of select that color. And I'm just going to press the delete button on my keyboard. And then basically it makes that transparent background. So I'm going to save it like that. And that way these can be dropped into my video. And as you see, there's the transparent background. So I can now resize them over here to maybe like a 70%. Let's do a 60%. So we have two different sizes. We can angle them here to like a 12. Click this little transform tool, and then you can move them around. And I can kind of layer them however I want, wherever I want them on the video. The next thing that I need to add is this little fancy part of my video where I have the parts of me popping up on the screen over here in this little trickle effect. And to do that, we're going to take the picture that I want to use, which is this one that I took down in Savannah, Georgia, and I just want myself cut out of it. I just want me and this little post that I'm sitting on so that way I'm not floating in midair cut out. And the way that I'm gonna do that is edit this photo, and I'm gonna select the lasso selection. Once you click down, you wanna keep clicking and you'll drag it around everything that you want. You have to hold your clicker down, have a steady hand, make it all the way around what you are trying to capture here. And once you've done that, you'll have a photo that looks like this. So as you can see, I have some rough edges here. You can still see parts of the background, which is totally fine, but I have myself with a transparent background, which is the important part. And I'm gonna open up this picture in the app that I showed you before, which is Sketchbook. And I'm just starting with a blank canvas. I'm gonna click the ruler button in the top menu. I'm gonna import an image, and I'm going to select to import this image. And what I'm doing now is basically moving around my layers because I want my doodle layer to be above my photo. And I'm going to select the brushes tool. I use underneath the textured essentials, the first one, which is the signature ink. And then I change my size to 20. I can select whatever color I want to use. Now in this photo, I used the yellow from the water bottle. So if I click the water droplet button, I can select the color that I want to use. I'm gonna bring it over to a yellow that I like, and I basically just draw my my outline around my body. This is what the photo looks like after I outlined it in the yellow that I want with the transparent background. So when I add that to my video, just like the Polaroids, I have a transparent background that I can now work with. And of course, we're gonna size myself down because I am way too big. I'm gonna use the transform tool and we're gonna move myself over to the corner, which is where I want it. And then to get the little trickle effect, all I do is copy and paste them about 4 or 5 times or however many times you want it to trickle. And I have them set up on different times to pop up. And now to the second chunk. And we're basically at square one, just with my background again. But we're going to move on to the next section of my header that I'm taking my inspiration from, which is this section right here. However, I did not vlog my trip to Florida, and so I do not have any footage directly from that trip. But I do have some Snapchat videos, which I thought of, and so when I go to my archive on my Instagram, and I'm gonna find some footage from Florida, I ended up using this video here of the sunset. Now this video, of course, is a different size and landscape, and so I can't get it to look exactly the same. So what I thought of was to, of course, just embrace the Instagram story Snapchat look of this video. I'm still gonna size it down to 90, and again, I'm going to use my simple border. We're gonna make that 10 and white, just like my other videos, so everything has a consistent look to it. I wanted to fill more space, and so I just copied and pasted this video 3 times. Again, taking away the audio, we don't want to hear this. And using my transform tool just to put them side by side. So that way this one video is now taking up the full screen like the previous section, but in its own way. And now we get to add the same little Polaroids that I added in the first section and the same little area of me popping out of nowhere with the transparent background and the doodles around it, which I do the exact same way. Now to switch things up from the first portion where my Polaroids popped out first and then I popped out second, I switched it up with the next portion by having myself pop out first, doing the same thing by using the lasso tool to cut myself out of a picture, airdropping it to myself using the sketchbook app to go ahead and draw the doodle around myself, and then I did the same thing with the Polaroids, uploading them to Unfold, and then again using my preview app to go ahead and cut out and make that transparent background, size them down, use the transform tool to move them around wherever I wanted them to be. The only differences, I thought that this one just looked a little bare. Like I wanted something else to be here, and I wanted to keep pulling from my aesthetics that you can see here and just basically what I use in my videos, which are a lot of these little doodles. I like drawing on my videos, using them for arrows, or just, you know, outlining myself, doing whatever I want to do, stuff like this. I wanted to incorporate my doodles into my intro, so that way my channel has a whole consistent theme. And for that, I'm going to use the sketchbook app again. And for this, I like to use the glaze brush, which is under artist, and the settings, I keep them about 80 or so because I like them to be a little bit bigger, and then I can go ahead and choose whatever colors I want, however you want to do it, all around the rainbow. And I'm going to start from the outside of the picture and draw inward. If you don't start off of the picture, you'll have like a harsh little start line, as you can see, but after I'm done deciding whatever I want this to look like, I make them all line up, we're going to save this and airdrop it to myself. And this is one that I actually made for this section. I wanted to use colors that were in the photos, and so I tried to pick a lot of warm, cooler colors. The picture itself is going to come with that white background. I just used the magic wand again and erased the background from it. And now, of course, looking at this, it was a little too big for me, and so I did size it down by using the transform tool. I can drag these little corners here, make it as big or as small as I would like, put it wherever I want it to, and voila, I have the doodle in the photo. However, I wanted to give it some movement so it wasn't just like a stagnant photo here. So I did add the underwater effect to the photo, and I gave it some different dimensions than the other underwaters. We're at a 2, 25, and a 15, so that way it kind of shakes ever so slightly. I don't even know if you guys noticed it, but it was just something light that I wanted to add, so that way we didn't have just a harsh doodle chilling there. Now the third chunk is super easy because I tried so hard to get it to look like everything else. I spent so long on just like 2 different portions, which you'll see, but I ended up just keeping them very plain, like the beginning footage. So landscape, normal footage. I'm just going to pull into my video, pick the portion that I want. We're gonna scale it to 90 again, and we added the simple border at 10 and white. So everything has that same look. And that is all I did for the third portion. I tried to add Polaroids. I wanted to add the doodles again. again, but I felt like it was just getting too repetitive at this point, and I settled on just this video. So now moving on to the fourth one, we did go back to some Polaroids and fun stuff where I pulled from this section of my header, which was again from spring break. And once again, I did not vlog that beach day specifically, so I only have footage on my Instagram stories, but I did find a cute little beach video from that day that I ended up saving on my phone and using. And so we dropped the audio, I picked the little portion that I want to show in the video, but this time I didn't want to do the same exact little three thing that you saw before. So then I got fancy, and we still added three, of course, as you saw, but this time I wanted to do it a little bit different when I moved them to the side, because once I did that, it just looked, again, too repetitive. I didn't want it to just be this cookie cutter intro that I copied and pasted six times. So I took the two surrounding images and I made them smaller to 80%. That way the middle stood out a little bit more and the two side ones were smaller. I think it just added a little bit dimension and some depth to it, just something visually appealing, I thought. And of course, I did the same thing with my image of myself using the app and preview. I used the same thing with Sketchbook to make the doodles, and I did the same thing with Unfold and Preview to make the Polaroids. I placed them all, lined them up with the music how I wanted it to be, and this chunk turned out to be one of my favorite little chunks. I think it's just the color scheme that I really like, but I like this section. Now at this point, moving on to the next chunk, I have run out of things to use for my header, because this main picture here was again from our Florida trip, which I didn't vlog. I have no Snapchats, no Insta stories, I looked. So I basically took more footage from spring break that I was using in my previous intros, and I put it in landscape style just like our other footage. We have it in at 90% scaled, the white border at 10, and I left it alone just like I did with this one. So there's slight consistency there where we have a lot going on, but then we have some simple footage going on. And then since we used a landscape, I kind of saw a pattern happening within my videos where I go landscape three, landscape three, landscape. And so for this last section, I was like, okay, I have to do three. But I picked footage from my Instagram stories from this day, which is when we went putt-putting. And I kind of alternated since last time we did the three scaled differently and before we did three regulars. So I went back to the three regular just for some consistency here. And of course, at this point, I am flying through editing because I'm keeping the same style. I used the same apps to do everything that I was doing, the same effects, going with the same music. And then the other thing that I was struggling with, though, is I had one little chunk left, literally from this red line to the white line next to it here. And so I decided to keep it going from this day themed because I do have landscape footage. I ended up pulling footage that I used in my intro previously and left it at the landscape to cover that last little chunk that I needed. And I did end up carrying over the doodles since it was all from the same day, just to keep that consistency. But we're not done here. So after this video drops off at that little beat, I go into kind of my old intro because I really like the way that I have it set up, where I feature the date of when the video is happening and then my little 1, 2, 3 Marissa Nicole. So we're gonna do that again, but I do it the same way that I made the Marissa Nicole here at the beginning. I'm using a basic text. I use my Cool Vetica. This second font here where the date is actually a Galvi, which I believe is already in Final Cut Pro. And last but not least, it's kind of the transition area to the video. So my audio, I like to cut off where this big break is in here. So I'm just gonna cut the audio right here because I am gonna drop down the loudness of it. Usually this kind of extends a little bit further. And I'm also going to drag this little dot, which is a fader, all the way over, because basically what I want to happen is it to fade into my words so it's not just a harsh stopping point into my video. But right here is kind of important. If you guys notice or you hear it, I usually have an effect of like a VHS tape, which I've shown. And so I am gonna add that on again, so that way everything slides down like a VHS. It matches the theme of everything that I'm wanting, but this doesn't come with any sound effects. And so to help it sound like a VHS, I add different sound effects that are in Final Cut. And I end up using the walkie-talkie, the record player, and the tape button. And I know you've already seen it, of course, at the beginning of the video, but now that you see how I did it, let's take a final look at how it turned out. And there you have it. That is how I made my my brand new intro, post-grad rebranding. I hope the video was informative. I hope it wasn't too confusing. I hope I explained everything. If you guys have any follow-up questions about this video, please let me know in the comments down below. I'll be happy to help you guys. And of course, if you guys want to see any other tutorials of how I do what I do here on YouTube, also let me know down below. I'd be happy to make them. But if you did enjoy today's video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, subscribe down below, and don't forget to follow me over on Instagram. I hope you guys enjoyed. I love you guys so much, more than you will ever know, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.